Greetings, everybody. Rhadamant here with another episode of my sea ice survival. So, on last episode, we got really lucky. Maybe not lucky. It was about time. But basically what happened was a bulk goods trader came and I was able to buy possibly my ticket out of here. That is my hope. So I've yet to be able to confirm that, but the first thing I need to do here is to try, and this might end poorly, but try to take these Thrumbo down, because they're wandering out of my zone. They're worth a whole lot of money and food. I don't have a lot of animal visitors here, like ever. And it is not quite cold enough to kill them, unfortunately. It's balmy for this zone. As such, I will need to do my best to try to take them down. So, what I'm doing here is equipping everyone with quick fire weapons, including Doc. Doc, you're in on this too. Rapid fire weapons. And I'm going to do like little door surprise attacks. And I hope that the turret holds up. But if it doesn't, it is replaceable. At the very least. Now what I'm hoping is that these two Thrumbo will separate from one another. But I don't believe they will. I think I have to take them on together somehow. But I do have a nice plasteel door protecting me from them. So I just have to play my cards right here. Now they're shivering, but they're not going to get much colder than that. Because they're comfortable up until about negative 85, so this is about as cold as they'll ever be. They'll max out at shivering, I'm pretty sure. So I'm going to consume meals with my last two people that are hungry. Oops. Alright, let's consume some meals. And get down to business. So I think I'm going to send Taffy. No, I'm going to send Engie. Engie's got longer range. I'm going to send... Taffy will do the door lure. But Engie will bring the pain here. Now, it looks to me like they're separating out, which means that I can aggro just one Thrumbo without having to piss off the other one. I think two at once would have been too much unless I use my Doomsday Launcher, but my Doomsday Launcher is still, I want to keep it as an insurance policy against insurmountable odds. And maybe it backfires on me, but that is a danger I am willing to take. So here we go. A little bit of the door tease tactic, where you pop out, you take one shot, you pop back in. The Thrumbo, of course, has no chance to break this door down. It is plasteel. And we continue to do this little tactic. Taffy might get a little beat up. That's why I had Taffy do it and not NG or Doc. But there we go. Thrumbo down. Now, I don't think that there's a possibility for Engie to catch this other Thrumbo. Yeah, I don't believe that I have a chance to catch it, but I will try. But before that, I'm going to have Taffy rest and get patched up so she doesn't bleed everywhere. But without medicine. Now, Taffy does have a bionic leg, so... What are you doing? Doc, what are you doing? I want to... Oh, outside a loud area. That would be my fault. Here we go. Yeah, that Thrumbo is long gone. I'm not even going to bother going for it. Oh, and the other one seems to be up. Which means I've got to stop it. I can't let my meat walk away, and I'm pretty sure it's not bleeding out fast enough to... This is annoying. It's quite a lot of blood. How fast are you moving? Because you're bleeding to death, you're hypothermic, you're still moving at 4. Yeah, you're moving half a cell slower than I am. Boom, NG ends it. Right away. In just a shot. And I get to haul my Thrumblehorn back. And Taffy will haul the corpse back. Taffy being our fastest, I'm assuming. Yes, our fastest colonist. By quite a bit, thanks to that bionic leg. So now we have 3 Thrumblehorns to sell. I do not believe... Given that I only have 7 silver left, it's not like I can even call for caravan. But I'm pretty sure caravans won't come. It is just too hot, or too cold rather, it's not hot enough for them to even bother to visit me. So one thing I'm a little contemplating here is whether or not to try to make some more turrets. I haven't done the calculations, and I'm sure I could, obviously, but I haven't done the calculations to figure out exactly how much of each resource I will need to leave. I was sort of hoping to get a bulk of my research done and queue it up to see. And I've already been informed that I made a mistake selling off my gold. But there was, you know, I should have kept the gold because I'll need some gold for the ship. But I should be able to buy the gold given the right vendor visiting me. So now that I have this Thrumbo here, it's a lot of good cooking. A lot of additional meat coming my way. It's too bad I couldn't get both, but I don't think I could have fought both at the same time without risking the integrity of the turret. So I did the best I could, given the circumstances. So I'm going to have Doc here. I guess she is not that stressed, so I'll have her keep doing what she's doing. But eventually I want to have her put back on research, maybe after moving that stuff. So let's get her queued up for research. So I'm going to restrict her back to the home area where she can research some of the remaining ship parts. Now I have a lot of the research already done. And some of the research is pointless, you know, like I'm never going to be able to really use, No, I guess I have mostly the useful research. I mean, it's not like I'll ever be able to use deep drilling or ground scanning or anything like that here, but I figured it didn't hurt to have the research anyway. So Engie's making a new parka, hoping that this husky fur is a better insulator, but I think it's just a normal insulator, so it's just at least something I can sell. Parkas are valuable, and they will sell for a lot, so that's the concept there. Taffy is cleaning up and hauling. Doc is back to research. The reason I let Taffy in is, A, she doesn't have bad traits. She dislikes men, but everyone's a man. Or everyone's a woman here. Everyone's a man. She's a proselyte and already has a bionic leg. And she is a night owl, which doesn't really bother me. I'll just keep her... I've restricted her to sleep during the hours that she doesn't like to work. So, as you can see, she's not having a problem with that. She should be going to sleep pretty soon here, actually. Since it's coming up at 11 o'clock and that's her... bedtime. Instead, she decides to take herself for a walk. That's fine. I'm going to snap her out of it so she consumes a fine meal and goes to sleep. And off she goes. And see, although it is difficult to deal with people who are nudists or are night owls, if you're able to micromanage them well enough, you have the benefit of them being happy being awake at night and asleep during the day and things like that. So there's mood there are mood modifiers that are positive if you can micromanage them well enough. And I'm not that great at micromanaging it, but good enough to get it done. So a group of mechanoids is coming for me. They're attacking immediately. They are two scythers and two... Alright, so I believe that I'll need Doc geared up for this. I already have the right weapons equipped. I have the rapid fire weapons. So these... Let's see. These... Let's flick this on. These scythers are almost here, so I really want to get ready for them. And I'm going to put people... I'll put NG right behind the door. Doc, I'm going to try to get in position first. I want to be out of sight for when they come. So what I'll do here is I'll let them inside, and then I'm going to give my turret power, and then I'm going to show my face and start to shoot them down as fast as I can. Now, I've been told that I should have doors here that... Oh, they're both down. That's beautiful. Doc and Engie will continue this fight. Against the centipedes. Who are en route, and what weapons do they have? A heavy charge blaster normal, and an inferno can is shoddy. Now they're about to be in range. I want to draw them away from the base here. Especially the Inferno Cannon. And that's the one I got. Because the Inferno Cannon will do a considerable amount of damage to the base. The other one is zoning in, but it's nothing my turret can't handle. They want to bash some walls, but they're going to eventually ignore the walls. And they've already downed that one over there. So they can go join Taffy here, who has a charge rifle. Awful charge rifle, but a charge rifle nonetheless. And I believe these scythers were downed, but they still have their blades attached. So I really hope to... Or three of four blades attached. I really hope to keep them alive and well so that I can exploit that. And grab their blades and take them from them. So one of the things I have to be careful of here is to get... Not to get shot. So... I'm trying to get some aggro going here on that turret. There we go. Because it's quite a lot of shooting that this caterpillar can do. It's going down pretty quick, though. This fight is almost over. It's injured almost critically. And that's a Thrumbo and four mechanoids that get added to my collection of dead things that I've pummeled relentlessly into submission with my very efficient little kill box. Could be better, and I'm sure I'll hear from many of you telling me how inefficient and stupid my designs are, but at least for now, let me be proud. Let me be proud of my wonderful little kill box, my hyper-efficient little kill box. Alright, we got one blade there. That's great. I can shut that one down. Failed in a catastrophic way. Which means I destroyed the blade. But that's okay. She tried, and that's what matters. So I got two blades out of that. And instead of just wasting man hours trying to shoot these things, I'm just going to order shutdowns. My shooting skill probably is fine. Yeah, maybe it could be a little higher, but I'm pretty satisfied with how fast my P90 people dispatch enemies. So the slag zone is full. But I'm going to have NG melt these down pronto. Doc, I'm probably going to put, after hauling this last piece of slag, back to research duty to try to get more research done. So I'm going to restrict Doc to the home area. I'm going to strip her gear and have her go, I guess, sleeping. That's fine. NG still pecking away at these mechanoids. Already 15 minutes in and two battles. Pretty good so far, I'd have to say. Not even taking a scratch from said battles. Actually, no, Taffy did get lightly cut, but nothing serious. So now I have a hell of a lot more components and plasteel, which is great. As you can see, I have steel for days. In fact, it's a little worrisome because my value has skyrocketed. The value of my community here has shot up immensely. Which means I need to watch my back. It's very possible that some of the future raids that come for me are going to be more than I can capably handle because of my increased value. Which is all the more reason to work on the research and try to get off this little rock as soon as possible. Now, once I have the blueprints and the sort of floor plan of the ship, I'll be able to use any excess plasteel and other resources, steel, plasteel, and whatever else, to better protect my colony, building more turrets and the like. Because certainly this kill box could have more turrets. You can solve almost every problem in RimWorld with more guns. Maybe not mood problems, but almost every other problem. So Taffy has done a pretty good job cleaning everything up here, as you can see. To the point where I think I'm going to ignore the rest of the bodies that are out there and have her just go after slag, because I could be, honestly, I mean, I could be burying bodies for years and never be done, given the amount of raids that I incur. I really don't think I will ever see the end of raids. So, with that in mind, you know, I'll just go on my merry way and ignore all the many bodies, and there are many. The many bodies that are out here, they're dozens. Dozens and dozens. So now I have my silver stashed away. I still don't think I can call anyone for a trade, but, you know, there's that. Alright, let's check this parka out. See if I don't know the properties of husky fur. They are... how does that stack up against camel hair? They are not nearly as good as the super parkas. The uber super parkas, but it's worth a lot. It's worth money, so whatever. So there's two classes of parkas. There's like the sort of leather parkas, which are negative 72, and then there's the super parkas of wool and camel hair, which are like negative 200-ish, depending on quality. And I didn't know how good, you know, that could have been. I wasn't sure, so I made one to find out. So now we're hauling the remainder of the rubble blocks. I'm trying to have them pick them up in one trip. There we go. Now, if you ever need to do something like that, you can just create a temporary stockpile and have them stockpile it to that one spot. But sometimes you can trick them out like the way I just did. It requires a little bit more moving around, but I didn't care. It was fine. So what is Taffy working on now? Oh, another raid of mechanoids. Alright, mechanoids. Alright, so I have a whole bunch of scythers coming. Three scythers and a caterpillar. Again, going to use more or less the same tactic. Gonna be out of sight, and then all of a sudden I will show myself. But I want to move this sniper rifle out of the way a bit. Alright, it's time for NG to get up. And NG doesn't have her assault rifle on. But she can easily beat the scythers into position. And maybe even... No, no time for a meal. Alright. Oh, there's four scythers. Jesus. Come on, game. Come on. Give me breaks. So, a bunch of charge lances. I mean, that's all they ever get. I'm just looking at the quality of their charge lance. Alright, so now that they're in, time to pray, really, because there's so many of them. As long as they're shooting at the turret, I feel pretty good. Two of the scythers have decided to go south, so I quickly am grabbing the sniper rifle to see if I can't encourage them to turn around. So I'm going to do that. Oh, one is coming back. So I have to dodge accordingly. They have broken some of the power lines out to this little outpost, but unless I have slaves, that serves not that much of a purpose. So I'm gonna have everyone come back into the zone. This Scyther is trying to shoot NG, so I'm gonna have her hide. Let Doc and Taffy go to town here. And I still have more time before this last, before the caterpillar comes, so I still have one more scyther to deal with. Could try to get a shot off before it gets close. Who knows? NG has downed scythers in one shot before, but not this time. Gonna turn the turret off so the scyther doesn't know to attack it. Nice little trick. Let it get really close in that kill box. And then you turn the turret back on, and then all of a sudden, it becomes a battle. They're pointing at Taffy. I try to get Taffy out of the way. She has suffered a pretty bad arm wound, but nothing that is fatal immediately. Alright, so before this caterpillar gets here, it's time to patch Taffy up. Now, call me a bit of an asshole, but part of the reason I even have Taffy is I have a pretty invested interest in Doc and NG making it out. But if Taffy doesn't, she's only joined in the last, in the last episode. So, as much as I'd like to ensure her survival, she's pretty much going to be the one taking the risks. That being said, I don't have any problem making her more bionic. So he has a charge blaster that's good, so I gotta be careful about that. Those things can really hurt. Alright, now that Doc is finished, I will have Doc join Angie out there. Angie just doing a perpetual kite and shoot. But two shooters, obviously better than one. Clearly I've let him get a little too close. Doc is not doing so great mood-wise. I need to get her naked again. I'll never get used to saying that, but that is the truth. Caterpillar down. Wow, these guys are really getting very efficient at murdering those things, huh? Very, very good at it. So they busted this up a little bit, but nothing that can't be repaired with just five blocks. And one steel. It's not a whole lot of repair costs. I'm going to restrict Doc to the house zone again so that she can get happy again. Dropping off her gear, scattering it really everywhere. Let's be honest now. So these Scythers also have some blades, I think. Yeah, one blade apiece. So I have two blades already. Somewhere. Here they are. Possibility of four blades. Which is pretty awesome. Pretty awesome. But the moods of my people are less than ideal. That's, I think, the nicest, easiest way to say it. So I'm going to have Taffy go haul this silver instead of hauling slag. And there's a few other things out here that I will want more than the slag. Hauling this beer, for instance, would not be bad. Or this other silver or steel. So there's still some... Oh! We have a power outage, so I need to go clothe Doc real quick. Else she'll be mightily cold. And I'll unrestrict her so she can wander around. So I just failed catastrophically on one of these guys. And I can do shutdown orders on them. My rice plants, of course, have died due to this solar flare. Solar flares are somewhat of the bane of the existence of the CI survival challenge, because you don't really have a source of wood at all to speak of. And you can't afford to just burn wood to try to keep your plants alive. So every time you have a solar flare like this, it's just like, good night, plants. That's it. It sucks, but, you know, that's just the way it is. So, we are 25 or 27 minutes into this video, and I fought Scythers twice and a Thrumbo. It is pretty miraculous that I haven't had more injuries than what has already happened to Taffy. Alright, so power's back up. I'm actually going to issue, I think it's pointless personally, but I'm going to issue a shovel zone here, almost purely for the aesthetic reasons, because I don't have much for my colonists to do. I figured, why not, right? At this point, they're hauling slag, and I could be having them haul some more important stuff, but, you know... most of the progress I want done is just research. So I'm putting Doc back on research now. When she gets in, the typical take off her gear, get back onto the research. So some niceties I could do, and I really want to save my components, but I could install some more Firefoam poppers. That would be helpful, especially if an Inferno Canon Scyther decided to raid me. That would be mighty necessary, in fact. Nope, not helping anyone else. Evgeny, sorry. I apologize. I'm not really in a position to offer an open door policy. So I think I'm going to remove the slag zone just to keep the area a little prettier because that slag is ugly. And I don't need... I can put slag here and it's not that far away. Alright, so now Engie's up. I'm going to have her disassemble more mechanoids. There sure are a lot of them. I'm running out of places to put their pieces and parts. It is interesting that because it's so cold, the pirate bands have not been attacking me. For a while there, I had a lot of pirate bands coming and sieging and stuff like that, and they just all freeze, and then I have to bury their bodies. It's kind of a pain. But lately, they have not even been showing up, I think, because they know they wouldn't survive the trip to my base, and if they did, I'd crush them. Or at least that's what I hope would happen. Who knows? I have been really, really lucky so far. I mean, I've had some close calls with Engie and Doc. And even Taffy now, that I've sent her into battle. But for the most part, I've got to say, I've been relatively lucky that the events that happen aren't super fatal and dangerous. They're not nuisances. Certainly, I've taken out, you know, a dozen or two tribes, and then I've taken out multiple Scyther raids, and I've been reading all your stories, and a lot of the stories that I've been reading from you guys have been like, Scythers killed me, or fire killed me. I mean, the threats that you face here are not insurmountable, but they are very serious threats. I mean, not to be trifled with, they're even a little fire in this base could kill me. If a little fire broke out and I wasn't able to handle it quickly, I'd die. You know, I'd be without a base, I'd be at square one, I'd have no food, I'd have nothing. Not a shelter over my head. I'd still have a lot of wealth in my colony, so it'd be sending me pretty sizable raids, and I'd be crushed. And I'm aware of that. You know, I'm aware of how tenuous my hold is on this map, which is why I was really excited to be leaving. To be honest, I was really excited to have the opportunity to actually succeed for once and survive. So I feel that is in my grasp. It is just a little gold and uranium away, a little gold research and uranium away, which is pretty cool. I thought when I started this CI survival, and you know, I might not get there. I want to preface, this is permadeath mode, and I might perish in the attempt of getting off this little rock, but I feel it's pretty close. Things are going pretty well, so. Sounds like famous last words, but yeah. Alright, come on. Wake up. Part of me, given that now that Engie is so damn good at construction, to just make new beds, just like take the... I think I should have 100 wood, but no, I have 65 because of Taffy's bed that I made, and it was only normal, so maybe I take that back. I was going to say, oh, she can make like masterwork beds, and they'll sleep and be so much more productive, but I suppose that isn't necessarily the case, even though Engie is... let's see... she is construction system class master. I mean, there's no one for a few light years that are better than her, is better than her at that. And for shooting, she's a strong master. She's getting up there. Yeah, she's really, really been improving very much. But there's just so much repair and stuff to be done around the base that's often why she's... you know, her construction and stuff like that is so high. So I'm actually pretty curious what next sort of raid they're going to throw at me, because so far I've seen a lot of just Scythers back to back to back to back. And don't get me wrong, I can handle Scythers, and actually Scythers yield some really, really powerful research. You know, they or not research, but resources. Because, you know, they're components and they're, you know, they do a lot for me. So I'm very happy that it's been sending me Scythers. But on the other hand, there is a very small possibility that pirates, if they came to raid me, would bring probably not uranium. No one really ever carries uranium around. It's very rare that a pawn will ever have uranium, but it's not actually that rare for them to have gold. Now, granted, having gold doesn't really help me unless I additionally have uranium, but it's at least one more thing off the checklist that needs to be checked for me to get out of here. So, other security things I could do is I could put some auto doors here and here, so that I can easily exit my base multiple ways. But I'm probably going to hold off on that for now, at least. Now, Taffy really likes to work at night. I keep thinking, oh man, I'm keeping Taffy up like well late into the night, but oh, so she has an old injury on her right arm now. So she's constantly in a little pain. I might install the pain stopper in her. But I'm not gonna race to it. It's not like her mood is really suffering. So it looks like I really only have the reactor left. I'm about to get propulsion. How far is it? I am 77 research away from getting the propulsion, which is just less than an hour. I mean, it's pretty good. So, Angie, instead of drinking that beer, how about you haul it back? You could drink it in the comfort of home. It's a hell of a lot of dead bodies. Okay, there we go. Research finished. Now off to the antimatter reactor. So this reactor will also act as a power source, which is pretty nice. I probably should have researched it first for that reason. But it'll be a power source to allow me to get off this rock. So another thing that occurs to me is I have a limited amount of components and a lot of steel. So before I dump all of my components into the ship parts, I probably should make a component bench and craft components. And it doesn't really matter where it is. I could even put it outside here, like right here, because it doesn't matter how fast it takes me to craft them. I'm not in any rush. I don't think I'm going to get the uranium anytime soon. But looking at it looks like if I was to get everyone off right now, it'd be 100 plus 5 per, so it'd be 115 uranium and 100 gold, which is very, very affordable. I have plenty of silver to cover that cost. Right, let's get you to finish this. Cargo pods. Watch it be like uranium. Nope, just meat. One could hope, but all right. Button down shirt. See the quality. Normal. All right, let's wear it. Oh, I was wearing a good one? Oh, but that's a t-shirt. I'm gonna keep this one on. This one gives me a little bit more insulation than a t-shirt, I think. Yes, it does. Just a little bit. All right, Taffy. Let's have you haul this silver. Given that I have like a crazy amount of slag out on the map, I mean, I have 21 chunks here, which is 210 steel, and there are so many chunks left, that component bench could really benefit me. Plus, I'm pretty confident I have enough steel for this. You know, I need 200, that's 1500, so 1700, another 200, so 19. Yeah, I'm not going to need all 3,000 steel plus the additional what's out there, I don't think. But I do want to get as much of this built. I want to queue it all up so I don't make any further mistakes about stockpiles or whatever. So we're coming up on 40 minutes, and we haven't had a, yeah, here's my wealth in the last 100 days. So you can see it's been going up and up and up. Here's the whole time. Oh, solar, oh, that's not a problem. Just one more component that I have to use, but not critical. Cargo pods that sounded really close. Of rice. Well, I'm pretty sure got a whole lot of that. Now, one thing I could do is change this stockpile zone so that the bottom here is slag. So maybe I'll go ahead and do that. So I'm going to have these three rows be slag. Steel slag. Just to slow down people when they're trying to get in. So chunks, steel slag. And that way, Taffy, when she's hauling stuff, she's at least being productive somewhat. In, you know, improving my defense by a marginal amount, but an amount nonetheless. So I just had a wanderer join me named B. An actor. And they're throwing a party about it. I don't really think I want another person. Especially now that I'm almost off this rock. So I'm going to exile B. I know how sad that sounds, but I'll give her warm stuff and some meals. I'll let her keep the meals she has. So she'll... Oh, she doesn't even haul stuff. Jesus. Well, B, you're really useful. Hey, you can even wear... Let's wear this one. So now her cold temperature is fine. Ooh, a combat supplier. All right. I'm not exactly sure what they're going to offer me here, but let's see. So a bionic arm, I will take. I will sell off this stuff. Oh, I need to move some of my silver before I can buy that bionic arm. But let's first move this, sell all of these crappy weapons to them. Too bad I can't break down a uranium shiv. I have a few of them, actually. Break it down to its components. You know, you can smelt it into steel, but that's all you can really do. Alright, so that's all that stuff. Now dead armor. Having that power armor would be pretty sweet. Not that I can afford it, but boy, would that be awesome, huh? Excellent power armor. Just be like, guess what? No one can touch me. Well, that's not exactly true, but... Alright, and I'm going to double check that I can't buy anything particularly useful from them. Which seems to be the case. They're not selling anything that gets me off this planet. So I'm going to prioritize this stockpile higher than the others and haul... Alright, Doc, I need you to wear some clothing right now. Haul the silver. Oh, what is the priority of this? Normal. Is this not... No... Oh, right, the restriction. I keep forgetting to choose this. Alright, so Doc, you haul the silver back. NG, you haul this silver. I'm gonna buy that bionic arm. because I have a colonist in pain, and I don't want that. All right, so now it's her right arm, so I'll allow some medicine for that. So be here. We'll be dropping her armor vest. And we'll be dropping her smoke leaf joints. She's a pothead. That's good to know. And give me a second to load up the world tab. I haven't loaded the world yet on this playthrough. I'll be sending her on a ice expedition that will end with maybe a flag in the ground. Maybe she can even make it to the ice sheet. Who knows? I doubt it, but who knows? So I'm going to give her plenty of food. Really, truly. Like, I'm giving her lots and lots of food here. So I'm not setting her up necessarily to fail. But there we go. See how far she gets. She can take all the milk and a bunch of meals and head on her way. So Doc, I'm going to restrict you again. Oh, that's not Doc. This is Doc. Escape pod. Mao. Well, you're not wearing anything, so even if I wanted to save you, you'd freeze. So another thing I could do with these smoke leaves is create a crafting spot. And, I can even put the crafting spot here. And queue up some smoke leaf joints. Alright, caravan's ready. You will be headed here. So it takes 3 days, and I have 8 days of food. So it's actually not inconceivable that I trade for that uranium via transport pod to, like, Actor's Village or something. It's not inconceivable, certainly. Let's try to visit them. That's about all the food I have. So that's another option. Once I have the framework of the ship built, I'll think about perhaps transport potting there. Alright, so I'm going to operate on Taffy now. Before I do, I'm going to clean up so I have the best chance of succeeding. Which means grabbing more medicine, I suppose. And no problem. No problem at all. Smooth as can be. Alright, let's say drop on floor. And we'll put a little stockpile here of smoke leaf. There we go. And another stockpile of, what is this? It is, what is this classified as? I'm sure you guys know, and you're probably some of you screaming at the screen, oh, smoke leaves are a raw resource of plant matter. Yeah, yes they are, you're right. So now I don't have to run back and forth every time I want to roll a joint. For a second, I saw Taffy was down medically, and I was like, oh god, what happened? And then I realized, oh yeah, that was me. I did that. Putting Doc back into the zone. Alright, so let's see. We have not gotten very far, but there's no way she's going to freeze. She's just wearing too much warm stuff. Oh, we are just smoking up the joint. Well, that's fine. Don't mind that. As long as they're happy, right? So these spoil, I assume, but it takes a long time, so... Not an immediate threat at all. So she is wandering because of her mood or whatever. Good for you. You reject me as your leader. So I've got quite a few smoke leaf joints now. Guess I'll expand this a bit. I'll have to remember that the Scyther blades are there for when I've got a ship willing to buy them. But 50 joints? It's not bad. Doing some reorganization of the base. I don't need necessarily these side zones anymore. I'm sure I'll need this one. But this one is closest to my ship, and it mostly has steel, so that's fine. Another escape pod. Alina, the taxidermist. I really should have... I mean, I certainly have benefited from the gear that they drop, but I should have thought about maybe not having people constantly fall from the sky. And wanderers join. I've abused wanderers pretty thoroughly. Alright, I'm gonna wait until I know exactly what kind of resources I need. Which is not that much longer. Might not be in this video. I'm coming up on the hour now. I'm 52 minutes in, but making progress, that's for sure. So B is still wandering around aimlessly around here. You are really going to run out of food unless you get a move on. Oh, you're withdrawing, that's why. I didn't leave you with any weed. You know artists and their weed, right? I guess. Now, I'm capable of making luxurious food now, or lavish food, I should say, but... That's too much. All right, so one of you said to just queue up a whole lot of cook order and then cancel it. I forget who it was, but it was someone in my stream, so I'm using your advice now. I'm just gonna crank out a whole lot of food and then suspend it for a while. Taffy is not really doing any valuable things right now. As you can see, she's just sort of wandering back and forth. But whatever. Alright, so I guess I'll go up to 40 here. Because I have space up there for 40, so. And this is when a fire erupts here and destroys all of my meals, right? Guess I could also get this meat too, before it spoils. So... How about you go get the fox meat? so that's more than enough for now. Alright, I'm just waiting for Engie to be done relaxing socially so I could grab the rest of the fox meat. And then I'll let her sleep. She is pretty tired. But, is this room very impressive? No, this is a workshop. I guess this counts as the rec room as well. I mean, I suppose that I could install this here and it will be more rec-like. Install it here. Of course, Taffy will get beaten by horseshoes, but you know, that's her problem, not mine. Alright, so she has not been moving very fast. Now, the trouble is, if I transport here to trade with them, for instance, getting home means I have to settle next to it with enough components to build transport pods, enough components and chem fuel maybe for transport pods to get home. It's kind of a complicated and needs to be well orchestrated trip. Now I could crank up my grow operation here to pump out more organics to be able to create chem fuel and launch another transport pod to my new space with chem fuel to get home. That's always a possibility, but I'm hoping that I can bypass that all and just get a passing ship to bail me out of my uranium deficit and my gold deficit. That is the hope. So I'm going to change the priority of this because pretty much it only has things that I want to immediately sell. So I'm going to haul the thrombo horn out there. And I guess the silver. And then change the priority of this to preferred as well. So none of this other stuff will get hauled out. Because none of the other stuff I really need to ever sell. Now I could use some of this space as a transport pod like selling area. Which wouldn't be necessarily a bad idea. Check up on B. So, B is actually the first time I've, like, left this map ever. Oh, speaking of fires. Not a bad one. But I'm surprised the popper hasn't, popped. I guess it needs to get hit personally by fire. But no real damage done. Lost a crop. And my battery went down during an eclipse, but I do have backup batteries if I need it. Guess the armor vest took a bit of a hit, though. Oh, but she's sad wandering again. She's really, having trouble out there. I would, too, if I was in a freezing cold hellscape, withdrawing from drugs and all alone. I'd probably be in no much better of a position than she is, but, I guess I should stop judging her so harsh. Now, if I really can't get a ship here, there's other ways I can get chem fuel. You know, I could get a transport pod, and my worry is it'd be a one-way trip. You know, granted, I could send Taffy to do it and try to transport pod the stuff home, but I really don't want to be sending anyone on a one-way trip. Ever. If I can help it. Just expanding the slag zone a little bit, because it seems to be filling up pretty good. Alright, eclipse is ending, so my power should be going back up. Now, I am hitting into a winter winters are always pretty rough here. But I'm pretty well equipped now, more than I've ever been before, to deal with bad winters. So I'm not super, super worried about the winters, but I am coming up on my hour here, guys. So you'll have to tune in another time to see what comes of B, which is likely freezing death, but what comes of B and the rest of my survivors, and if I ever make it off this rock. So thank you for watching, and if you appreciated it, please let me know in comments or feedback and likes and subscribes, and I hope to see you on next episode. Thank you for watching.